In this video, I will show you how to set up your online courses in just a few minutes on Skillplate. I will start with an online course since it has the most features, and once you learn how to set that up, the other products will follow the same logic, so you will learn a lot about how to set up those as well. Go to Products, Online Courses, click the New Course button. You can start from scratch or use the AI generation feature to give yourself a boost. Let's first give it a name. I like to start fast using the What for Who template. For example, copywriting for marketers, as it helps the AI give us better results. Choose a category and click generate. Using the AI generation feature will speed up the process and set up a bunch of things automatically. When you click this button, we dynamically create a council of AI agents that impersonate experts in the course subject matter, and they discuss what to include in the course curriculum and prepare the course description, which you can use for your landing page copy. This usually takes about a minute, and once it is done, you can open the course settings. On the left, you have the curriculum. It consists of modules and lessons. The modules are these white boxes here, and they are just groups containing lessons, but there are a few module settings that you can change by clicking on the module name. Each module has a name that communicates what's inside it. Modules can also have downloadable resources and a quiz or exam at the end. And upon completion of the module or the exam, you can grant a branded certificate. Modules can also be enabled, meaning visible to all customers, or be a draft for when you need to add more content to your course, but it's not ready yet to release to the customers. And finally, you can drip modules by using the coming soon or drip date functions. The gray boxes inside modules are the lessons. When you click on them, you can see the lesson settings. Lessons obviously have a name. They can contain a video, text, resources, and have settings for enabling or disabling them. You will also find the drip settings on the right and the lesson resources section. Also, once you add a video, you can add subtitles in multiple languages. On the top right, you will find the general course settings. Those are important details and settings that will appear on your website and landing pages, so you should prepare them with the utmost care. Of course, we have a title, subtitle, and description. In the description, you can add multiple sections using the What You See Is What You Get editor. You can paste or embed videos with a link from YouTube or Vimeo, as well as embed videos using an iframe. You should know, however, that if you host videos outside of Skillplate, which we do allow, you will lose critical tracking and marketing features that can significantly increase your sales, so we recommend it only for free courses. It is actually very dangerous because you will save just a few pennies on hosting, but lose top dollar on additional sales. You can add images and even embed custom code if you need to collect feedback, get users to provide some information, or even do some homework. You can get creative with this. As you can see, the AI has already generated a description answering the most important questions that people have in their mind when they're buying a course. And you should also answer those questions in your landing pages and descriptions. Think about what the course is about, why should I buy it, what am I going to learn, who is the teacher? Has anyone bought it? Do you have any credentials or testimonials? And add those to the description. Under the description, we have the pricing section, where you can decide to make your product a freebie or add different pricing plans like one-time payment, subscription, or installments. You can add multiple options, and if you have a custom landing page for your product, you can conveniently find the checkout link for your product here. But before you can add pricing plans, you need to set up your payment settings to be able to accept payments. You can also enable the Discord integration, which will also grant people access to your Discord server upon purchase. You can even choose which roles they would get, so you can have multiple Discord tiers based on what products people have access to. This is most commonly used to provide access to your community with the purchase of a given product. On the right side, you have the product status. By default, when you create a module or lesson, they are made as drafts, and you can change that by clicking these two check marks to save a ton of time. In the sales channel settings, you can list your product in the automated website by clicking the listed checkbox and enabling cross-sale will allow people to purchase the product from inside the members area. The enrollment settings are super awesome. You can run a pre-sale and start selling even before your product is ready. By clicking the launch date button, you can add an exact date when people who bought it can access the content, and you can limit the number of people who buy it if you have limited spots, and also put a last date for signing up. In the content settings, you can force people to watch the modules and lessons in the order you intended, and you can even force them to watch every video to the very end. But be careful with this power, as it can sometimes be felt as negative. You can also automatically number modules and lessons. A pro tip, do not ever number the lessons of your courses while recording, because you don't know if you might need to add more stuff or use that lesson in a different course or change the numbers. Trust me, no numbering in the videos or titles. I speak from painful experience. Just use this feature, it's actually very good. Then we just add a thumbnail, attach links and additional resources or exercise files, add the course lecturer name, bio and socials, and voila, your course is almost ready. You can also set up a custom welcome email, and you can open the course landing page by clicking the view page button to bask in the magnificent glory of your brand new product. If you did not use the AI product generation, the landing page might be disabled by default, so you need to click here to enable. You can tweak this page slightly by adjusting the content, but the biggest value in it is that you get it instantly. And it also has a very high conversion rate because people are used to seeing course pages that look exactly like that. One thing that I always like to do is to add a pitch video to present the course, present myself, and what people are going to learn, what they're going to get out of it, and how it will change their lives. Note that any exams, subtitles, or resources you add will also be displayed on this page, as well as when it was last updated. Now, let me show you how you can create a fully branded and customized landing page for your brand new course using the Skillplate website builder. Go to the website tab, choose either the dark or light theme depending on your branding, and install it. I have already set up my branding settings here, and I will show you how to use the website builder to its full potential later on, but for now just go to the product pages and select your course page. By default, it will contain just three sections: the featured product section, the course curriculum, and the call to action section. But let's spice it up some more. Go to settings and select the featured product section. You will see all the section settings. Again, for more info, check the website builder video, it will have all the details. For now, I'll just add a few bullet callouts. Now, let's add some more sections. I like to add a pitch video by adding a video section, and you can also add some free preview videos from your course by adding a video gallery. You can select the videos from your uploads or add them from YouTube. You will also notice in the gallery section settings that it has blocks. Some sections which contain multiple content blocks will have those blocks displayed so you can edit their settings. You can also do that by just clicking on the block itself. Now, let's add some trust factors by adding a logo wall with the course partners, a numbers section to showcase the achievements of our students, and a section about the lecturer. You can change the order of sections by leaving the section and going to the page layout. From there, just drag and drop the sections to rearrange them. I also like to add a few feature sections to showcase what people are going to learn and why they should buy the course. Now, let's add some testimonials and a frequently asked questions section, as well as some related products. In my case, this course is part of my mega bundle, so I can also add that as a featured product. Finally, when a page gets a bit longer, it is a good idea to add a few call to action sections just to check if people are convinced already. I like this simple call to action, so let's add that. Let's fix the alignment and the layout, and change the style to make it stand out a little bit. You can also duplicate it to add it to more places on the website. Now, how about that? Isn't this a professionally looking page? Fast, beautiful, SEO friendly, and even though it was done in just a few minutes, it works on desktop, tablet, and mobile. Now it's time for you to go and make your own page, your own product, and start making your first sales. And I'll see you in the next video.